Well, this is my third video on my DIY lens holder for the Sony Xperia Pro-I, and it's my third attempt to get it right. Let's see what I did this time to remedy the issues that I had with this particular one. So this is the original DIY lens holder that I made for the Sony Xperia Pro-I. I used a lens step-up ring. I believe it was a 47 to 49 millimeter for this one. I'm not gonna go over how I made this. I already made a video on that and I'll just include the link. But I wanna go over some of the issues I had using this particular setup. You can see right away that the telephoto lens is covered by this ring. And you only get access to the main 24 millimeter and the 16 millimeter camera up there. This lens step-up ring does not cover up the flash and the, I believe it's the RGB sensor, but for certain ND filters or other types, it does cover it. So I'll install it right now. And you can see here that it does cover up the flash and that sensor too when you look at it. But you have to be careful if you decide to go with this particular size. Now, what's good about this size, it's a little bit more compact. It's not humongous. It doesn't stick out like some others. And if you want something like this, then this might be a good option. I've talked about frequently in my Xperia Pro-I videos that I have a chronic overheating issue with it in temperatures 30 degrees Celsius and above. So with this particular case, I did cut out part of the side to allow more cooling, and also I wanted easy access to the shutter button. But what happened was it weakened this corner right here. And you can see here, even though I glued it, it's coming apart again. What I am worried about is that this might fail and the Xperia Pro-I will just fall out and onto the ground. So those are some of the issues that I was having with this particular version. Now, the epoxy that I did use is extremely strong. I have never had this come off. And I've been in some pretty high temperatures and it has held up very well. And actually the only weak thing about this case is this corner here. So now let me go over what I did with a more improved version here. So here is the new version that I made. You can tell that the step-up ring is a lot larger than the one that I was using previously on this one here. So you can see the difference. This is a 52 to 55 millimeter step-up ring, so a lot larger than this one. And you can see here that this time what I did was I sacrificed the ultra-wide camera and I want to go ahead and just use the main 24 millimeter and the 50 millimeter here. Since I do a lot of video work with the ND filter, these are the two lenses that I use the most compared to the ultra wide. And you can also see in this one, you get full access to the sensor and the flash here. So even if I put on an ND filter, it does not cover up these two sensors. And that was a question that some viewers brought up. Does this lens holder cover up these two sensors? Let me go ahead and throw on the ND filter so you can see what it looks like. So this is what it looks like with a 55 millimeter ND filter on it. It is a lot larger than my previous setup. So for some of you who want a more compact, discreet look to this, that is not going to happen with this one here. If we turn this around here, you can see that I decided to keep the edging here so that the case will not fail on me. But the problem, of course, is the cooling. So I think if I'm gonna use this in 30 degrees Celsius plus temperatures, I think this is gonna heat up real fast. So I have to figure out some way to put either a cooling device here or try to keep my Xperia Pro-I cool until I'm ready to record with it. So you can see here with the ND filter on, you still have full access to those two sensors. And that is one issue I resolved from the old lens holder. I made this particular lens holder the exact same way as the old one, so please check out the link in the description below if you're curious on how I made this one. I don't like my buttons to be covered up, especially the shutter button here, but I don't want to sacrifice the strength of this case just for the tactile feel of the shutter button. It's better to have a strong case than having this exposed. I don't have the ND filter on right now. This is not to show how it looks with the ND filter, but to check if the lens holder does get in the way of the three lenses. I will do another video with this setup outdoors using an ND filter. This is the 24mm lens. You can see that the lens holder does not obstruct its view. Let me go ahead and switch over to the 50mm lens. You can also see here with the 50mm lens, the lens holder does not get in the way of it. So you are safe to use this particular lens holder with the 24 and 50mm lens. Now let's go to the 16mm lens. And here is the 16mm lens. You can see off to the left side here, that is part of the lens holder. Now, some of you may like the look that this is giving, but you can see you're not able to use the ultra-wide lens with this particular setup. So I'm really happy with this one, but this is a DIY project. It's a work in progress. I'm testing it out. I'm going back, I'm trying to fix it and see if things do need to be improved or not. And my style of vlogging, I'm very rough. I do a lot of outdoor vlogs. I bump my stuff around. And I felt that the way I did it here was the most secure for my ND filters. The last thing I want is this to come off during recording. You can make this a lot cleaner if you can find some way to attach the lens holder to the case without having to use this epoxy. But the epoxy helps give it more holding power to the case. These lens holders tend to be very thin on the back, so you would need to find something extremely strong to glue to the case. But that will give you a very clean look, and you don't have to worry about painting all of this stuff right here. Another thing I noticed when making this one is don't use a quick setting epoxy, especially when they promise it dries really quick, because what happens is you can't get that smooth appearance here because it's drying too fast. So avoid those if you want to go with this method. You will be able to get a lot cleaner look than I did with mine. So that's it, everyone. This is my third update on my DIY lens holder for the Sony Xperia Pro-I. If you're new to my channel, I do videos on health and fitness. I review various gadgets and I give tips for creating content on YouTube. If you like this video, please hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed, please help me out and subscribe. I try to release an interesting video every week, but I only do this part-time, so please bear with it. It's gonna be at least once a week or once every 2 weeks I release a video. Until next time, stay safe, keep learning. See everyone in the next video.